Welcome to the What is an Exponent video from MathCelebrity.com. In the next few minutes, I'm going to walk you through what is an exponent, why you use them, and then the various exponent properties you can use with variables and numbers. So let's get started. What is an exponent? An exponent is shorthand for representing how many times a number or a variable is multiplied by itself. Now, why would you use exponents? Well, if you're representing very large or very small numbers, it's an easier way to break down the number and read it and see how the number's constructed. So let's look at integers raised to a positive exponent. This is the simplest example of using an exponent. Suppose we want to take the number 2 and multiply it by itself 3 times. We're used to writing 2 times 2 times 2, as you see here. But what if there was an easier way? Well, we can use exponents as follows. We take the number 2 and we raise it to the number of times we want to multiply it by itself, in this case 3. Now we read this as 2 raised to the 3 or third power, where 2 is the base and 3 is the exponent. And both of these expressions equal each other. So 2 times 2 times 2, which is how we usually write it, is equal to 2 to the third. And they're both equal to 8. Now we can do the same thing with variables and raise them to a positive exponent. Suppose we want to take the variable x and multiply itself by itself 3 times. So we have x times x times x. We can use exponents just like we did with numbers as follows. We take the variable x and raise it to the number of times we'd like to multiply it by itself, in this case 3. So x is the base and 3 is the exponent. And both of these expressions equal each other. So x cubed or x raised to the third power equals x times x times x. Now that we've covered the basics of exponents, let's walk through a couple rules that you can use with exponents as well to help simplify your math. First, let's cover the product rule for exponents. So given a number a with exponents m and n, which I've shaded here in red and blue, we have a to the m times a to the n is equal to a raised to the m plus n. What this means is when you multiply a number by itself with different exponents, you can add the exponents and raise the number to the added exponents. So let's simplify that with actual numbers. Let's take a equals 5 and we'll take the exponents m equal 4 and n equal 3. Using the product rule, we have 5 to the 4th times 5 to the 3rd equals 5 to the 4 plus 3. Simplifying this, we get 5 to the 7th. Now, we want to see if this rule holds. So we evaluate the left side. 5 to the 4th is 625. 5 to the 3rd is 125. 5 to the 7th is 78,125. If I multiply 625 times 125, I do indeed get 78,125. So this is a nice numeric example of the product rule. Let's move on to the quotient rule for exponents. Given a number a with exponents m and n, we have a over m divided by a, or I'm sorry, a to the m divided by a to the n is equal to a to the m minus n. So when you do the quotient rule, you're subtracting instead of adding. Let's take a numeric example. We'll do the same one we did with a product rule. A equals 5 with exponents m equals 4 and n equals 3. So we have 5 to the 4th over 5 to the 3rd equals 5 to the 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 evaluates to 1. So we have 5 to the 1 equals 625 over 125. Well, 5 to the 1 is just 5. So we do indeed see that 5 equals 5. Now let's move on to our third rule for exponents. We call this one the power of a power rule. So given a number a with exponents m and n, we have a to the m raised to the n equals a to the m times n. Let's take a numeric example. Let a equals 5 with exponents m equal 4 and n equal 3, and we have 5 raised to the 4 all raised to the 3 equals 5 to the 4 times 3. 5 to the 4th evaluates to 625, and we want to raise that to the 3rd power. 5 to the 4 times 3 is 5 to the 12th. If you run these two numbers through a calculator, 5 to the 12th and 625 to the 3rd, you will get the same number, 244,140,625. So once again, we've shown this with a numeric example. Let's move on to the power of a product rule for exponents. Given a number a and a number b with exponent n, we have the power of a product rule as follows. A times b raised to the n, all raised to the n, equals a raised to the n times b raised to the n. So once again, let's walk through this with a numeric example. With a equals 4 and b equals 3 and n, which is our exponent of 5, we've got 4 times 3 raised to the 5th should equal 4 raised to the 5th times 3 raised to the 5th. So if we evaluate and simplify, we've got 12 to the 5th times 1024 times 243, and these both evaluate to 248,832. Moving on to the next property, the power of a quotient rule for exponents. If we take a number a and a number b with exponent n, we have the following rule, the quotient rule. A over b raised to the n equals a to the n divided by b to the n. Once again, let's take a equal 4, b equal 3, and n equal 5, and we get 4 over 3 all raised to the 5th power should equal 4 raised to the 5th divided by 3 raised to the 5th. Evaluating and simplifying, we get this line here, and we see that they both, using a calculator, equal these numbers. So once again, we've shown a numeric example of another exponent rule. Now to close this out, I want to cover two more general rules for exponents. The first is the negative integer exponent rule. If we have a number a with an exponent negative n, we have the following identity. A raised to the negative n can also be written as 1 over a all raised to the positive n. So anytime you have a negative integer, you can do the reciprocal of the number and raise it to the positive power. Finally, the zero exponent rule. And you may have learned this earlier with numbers, but the same applies to variables. Any number a or variable a raised to an exponent of 0 is 1. So read differently, any number or integer or variable raised to the 0 power, or 0 as an exponent, equals 1. So that's it for the main exponent powers and identities. And if you ever have exponent problems that you like to run through our calculator, we will show those identities as well. So I want to thank you for watching the exponent video, and I will see you in the next video.